The following is a special sports presentation of UltimateSportsTalk.com. UltimateSportsTalk.com now presents Mount St. Joseph University men's basketball. Tonight's game is being brought to you by the Mount St. Joseph University, Audacity, Dayton Children's Hospital, The Roar Store, and UltimateSportsTalk.com. And now it's time for Mount St. Joseph University basketball. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Harrington Center on the campus of Mount St. Joseph University here in Cincinnati, Ohio. It is a gorgeous, frigid Wednesday evening, but warm as toast here inside the Harrington Center as the Lions come home to take on the Bluffton Beavers. Both of these teams are desperate for a win in the Heartland Conference. As a matter of fact, the Lions probably more so than the Beavers. The Beavers on the road this year come into tonight's matchup with a record of 1-6 on the road. They are 4-15 overall and 2-11 in the Heartland Conference. But that is not good enough to overtake the Mount St. Joseph Lions, who come into tonight's ballgame with a record of 6-13, and they are 5-7 in the Heartland Conference. These two teams met back in December, in November actually. It was one of the final days of the month of November 2022 up in Northwest Ohio, and the Lions came away with a loss 57-50 to the Beavers. That was their first win in the conference. They have only had two in conference play coming into this evening's contest with the Lions. The Lions enter the matchup tonight after falling at Rose Holman on Saturday, 67-57. But the Mount has played their best when they're right here at the Harrington Center. They are 5-2 at home this season and hope to improve on that mark tonight. Sophomore center Luke Collinsworth and forward Dane Gardner have been a force in the paint for the Lions over the past few games. Collinsworth leads the team in points with an average of 14.6 per ball game, while adding 4.6 rebounds per game. Gardner has done everything for the Mount this season. He's averaging 8.3 points per ball game, 5.3 rebounds, and 2.2 assists this year. Collinsworth, we told you, 14.6, and he's grabbing just under 5 rebounds per ball game. He is going to be playing tonight with a bum thumb. Try saying that quick 3 times. A bum thumb, because he hurt it yesterday in practice. So that's going to be, we're going to have to keep an eye on that here tonight for the Lions. Nate Kratzer may get a lot more playing time tonight for the Lions than he normally would at that center position. But good news is that Jack Kolar is back in the lineup tonight. Kolar sprained his shoulder a few weeks ago. He has been cleared by the doctor to play. He'll be back in at his shooting guard position. The 6'2 senior comes in averaging about 8 points per ball game, and the Lions desperately could use his outside shooting in this one here this evening against Bluffton. The Lions' defense has been the key to their wins all season long. So far, the Lions rank 3rd in the Heartland in points allowed, giving up just 65.1 on the year. In the meantime, for Bluffton, they are averaging just 56 points per game. That's all they're averaging overall throughout the season here tonight, and they're giving up 71.6. So that is almost, folks, 10 points more than what the Lions are allowing. It's 62.6 offensively is what the Lions are scoring, and they're giving up 65 a ball game. The Mount leads the all-time series 28 wins against 22 defeats, and this will be the 51st meeting between these two ball clubs, and it's going to be the last meeting that Toby Kerrigan and Guy Neal will be undertaking against each other here tonight at the Harrington Center. I'm Dave Mitchell. We're just moments away from tonight's ball game between Bluffton and Defiance, and when I come back, we'll talk about what else is happening around the Heartland Conference and talk about your Bluffton Beavers. We'll do that after we come back after this.
Now on the Mount St. Joseph campus, it's the Roar Store. Located in the Harrington Center, the Roar Store is designed to meet the needs of our students, whether it's spirit wear, gifts, or snacks. But the Roar Store is more. They offer everything from notebooks to laundry detergent, even brake fluid and tire repair, plus a wide range of food and drink. And it's just a walk away. It's not just a bookstore, it's an everything store. The Roar Store in the Harrington Center on the campus of Mount St. Joseph University.
Teaching is my calling. So when I needed to renew my license, I chose Mount St. Joseph University. The Mount offers the only program in the state of Ohio that allows you to combine two education endorsements to earn a graduate degree. In less than 2 years, I combined the reading and gifted intervention specialist endorsements. Classes were convenient, fully online, and I received personal attention from my professors. The Mount helped me climb higher in my career. Begin your ascent at msj.edu/Ohio.
Well, very quickly, a couple of scores around college basketball, especially here in Cincinnati, where Xavier is leading over 17th-ranked Providence 37-26 at the Cintas Center over near Xavier University. The Cincinnati game tonight has not gotten underway as of yet. We're about 18 minutes away from the tip-off of tonight's ball game. The Lions come in with a record of 6-13, and they are 5-7 in the Heartland Conference, but here at home, they are 5-2. On the road, Bluffton has not been playing good basketball. They are 1-6 on the road this year. Now at home, it's a different story for Bluffton, as it was in the first game back on November the 30th when the Lions were just out-physicaled. They played that game without the big guy in the middle, Luke Collinsworth, and he'll be back tonight, but still, the Lions played that game without Luke, and they were out-rebounded, and they were outshot in the middle of that one in a 57-52 defeat. For Bluffton, they enter the matchup in a 7-game losing streak after falling to Transylvania this past weekend. They lost to them 67-43. The Beavers are led by senior Keegan Owen and junior Michael Stammen. Owen leads the Beavers in scoring average with 12.2 a game, and he also grabs just under 3 rebounds a contest. Stammen leads the team in minutes played, while he's averaging 8.9 points a game, 4.2 rebounds, and 3.7 assists. This is going to be the last meeting of the year between these two ball clubs. The Lions lead it, the all-time series, 28 wins against 22 defeats, and that includes the loss that the Lions had back on November 30th, 2022, up in Bluffton by that 7-point margin. The Lions were down big at the end of the first half, 28-17, and then staged a comeback, but it was just too little too late as they ran out of gas in the last 3 minutes of the ball game after outscoring Bluffton 33-29, but they still were beaten by those 7 points at 57-50. Leading the way for the Lions is Kelvin Turner, but he's not playing tonight. He's got that sprained thumb. Turner, 17 points in the ballgame for the Lions that night, but yet he was the only player in double figures for the Lions. The next highest scorer for Mount St. Joseph was 6 points each to Nate Kratzer, then 6 points to Trey Dunn, and 6 points to Jack Kolar in the ballgame. Two of those three players are still with the team in Jack Kolar and Nate Kratzer. Meanwhile, for Bluffton, they were actually led in scoring by freshman Brady Wheeler. Now, Wheeler is out of Lima Shawnee High School, and boy, he was a prized recruit for Guy Neal in his last year. And Wheeler at 18 to lead the way. 13 went to Keegan Owen in the contest, and those were the only two players in double figures for Bluffton. After that, they had four, Michael Stammen had four, J.D. Stokes had four, with 3 points in the ballgame. Nevin Robson, Marcus Bruns, and also Ryan Rose. And rounding out the scoring for Bluffton in that ball game was Connor Martin. Martin had 2 points on 3 of 4 from the charity stripe. We've talked just a little bit about this. We've alluded to it since we started our pregame show. This will be the final time that Guy Neal coaches the team against the Lions here at the Harrington Center, as earlier this year he announced his retirement after 32 years of coaching at the University of Bluffton. And boy, has he put some guys in the high school coaches' maps around the state of Ohio. Rob Sheldon, his two sons, David and Chris Sheldon. He's also got Rick Geiser up at Wayndale in Apple Creek, Ohio, that has gone to the state tournament in girls basketball 2 years in a row. I mean, you look at just the coaching tree that Guy Neal has provided as head coach of the Beavers. It is quite impressive. And during his 32 years at Bluffton, he has garnered 371 wins and been beaten 432 times. Just an outstanding performance by Guy Neal retiring at the end of the year. But he's still got a few games left to go before his retirement takes place, and he wants to get wins in most of those ball games heading into tonight's conference encounter against the Mount. When we come back, we'll take a look at what's happening around the Heartland Conference. We'll do all that when we come back after this.
Dayton Children's cares about the health of your children. Hi, I'm Kirk Herbstreit. Growing up in Centerville, my parents taught me the importance of being healthy, and now I'm teaching my kids. Childhood obesity is on the rise, but there are small steps that we could take to fight it. Turn off video games and go outside, ride bikes, go to the park, or learn a new dance. Parents, once we get moving, our kids will follow.
Yeah! Get moving!
Dayton Children's, experts you trust, caring for the children you love.
When I needed to renew my teaching license, Mount St. Joseph University offered the only program in Ohio that allowed me to combine two education endorsements to earn a graduate degree fully online. The Mount helped me climb higher. Begin your ascent at msj.edu/ohio.
And we're right back here at the Harrington Center on the campus of Mount St. Joseph University. One note, the Lakota Quest High School basketball team, the boys team, is coming to tonight's ball game. They will be here to cheer on the Mount and their former teammate, Luke Collinsworth from Lakota West, plus the Lions, of course, they'd like to bring in a high school team almost every year, and they try to do that, and they are here tonight getting ready for this one at the Harrington Center. Well, when you look at this ball game here this evening, there are a lot of other games that are going to be going on around the conference. Now, let's take a look at women's basketball, where there is one game going on tonight, and we're going to keep a very close eye on it, and that is the Mount St. Joseph women up in Bluffton taking on the Bluffton Beavers. That game is going to get underway at 7:30, same time this one does, but we'll be watching that one very closely for you here tonight, because the Mount St. Joseph women need a win, and they want to stay in the hunt to pick up that third slot in the Heartland Conference. We'll talk about the standings coming up here in just a little bit. But while we've got the opportunity, let's take a look at the scores from Saturday in women's basketball in the Heartland. Hanover defeated Defiance Saturday, 67-55. It was Anderson blowing out Earlham, 83-44. Franklin lost to Manchester on a last-second bucket, 68-67. And Transy beat up on Bluffton in women's basketball, 65-42. No surprise there, because Transy right now is ranked number 2 in the top 25 Division III women's basketball rankings nationally. Now tonight in Heartland Conference basketball, it is Transylvania at Franklin. That game tipped off at 7. So did Hanover at Anderson. Defiance will be at Manchester. That tips off at 7:30. And that is a look at the games around the conference here tonight. So here's the standings in women's basketball. And you'll see it is a very jumbled mess, but only by the slottings of where the women are going to finish for the tournament. Transylvania, number one, they're 12-0 in the Heartland. But just a game right behind the Pioneers is Hanover at 11-1. Then comes Anderson in third place at 9-4. The Mount is at 8-4. They're just a half a game behind Anderson. But because they have beaten the Ravens twice this year, they win the tiebreaker between the two ball clubs. Bluffton and Franklin are both at 7-6, and there comes Manchester at 6-7. So you've got 7 of 9 teams that are battling for 6 spots in the tournament that's going to be happening in about 3 weeks. In men's basketball action over the weekend, let's take a look at what happened on Saturday around men's basketball action in the Heartland Conference. It was Hanover defeating Defiance 95-82. Transylvania beat Bluffton by a final of 67-43. Earlham, unbelievable, upset Anderson 70-62. And it was Manchester over Franklin by a final score of 80-67. The Lions, as we told you earlier, fell at Rose Holman by 10 points in the ballgame. So tonight around the conference, a look at the schedule shows games all tipping off at 7:30. Anderson is at Hanover. That is going to be a classic tonight. Franklin will be at Transylvania. Manchester goes to Defiance. Bluffton here at Mount St. Joseph, and Earlham will be at Rose Holman. Saturday, Hanover is at Earlham. Rose goes to Bluffton. Franklin will be at Anderson. Defiance goes to Transylvania. And the Mount will be up in Manchester taking on the Spartans in that one. So here's the men's conference standings. Anderson, after their loss on Sunday, they need a win tonight, and they are playing Hanover, but they've got a 10-2 record. They are still on top of the Heartland Conference by a game over Manchester at 9-3. Then comes Franklin, tied with Hanover at 8-4 on the year, so they're tied for third. Tied for fifth is Rose Holman and Transylvania, and then in the seventh spot is Mount St. Joseph at 5-7. Earlham at 3-9, Bluffton 2-10, Defiance at 1-11 are in the bottom third of the conference standings, and they have no shot at making the conference tournament. So it is Mount, Transy, Rose, Hanover, Franklin, Manchester, and Anderson that all have an opportunity to make the playoffs. But I'll tell you right now, folks, it is going to be extremely difficult for the Lions to get into the tournament. They've got to win almost every game and win out, not only here at the Harrington Center, but on the road. When we come back, we'll talk with head coach Toby Kerrigan after this.
Coach, first question. Have we talked about it in these?
At Mount St. Joseph University, our mission is to provide students with an affordable, world-class education in a safe, comfortable, private school setting. Nearly 100% of our incoming undergraduate students receive scholarships, grants, or financial aid. And with small class sizes and a 98% undergraduate career placement rate, the Mount leads the way in educational value and student success. Discover your potential. Discover the Mount at msj.edu/admissions.
Across divisions, sports, championships, and schools. For nearly 500,000 student athletes, college sports create lifelong opportunity, and that starts with education. We've raised the academic bar so more are earning degrees, creating healthier campuses by working with the nation's brightest minds, and making sure more have the chance to succeed and are supported on their journey. But beyond the numbers, it's about opportunity, and we're working to provide it for every student athlete.
So glad you're back here at the Harrington Center. I'm Dave Mitchell. Bluffton comes into the ballgame with a record of 4-15 overall. They have lost 7 in a row, and they are 2-11 in the Heartland Conference. They lost to Transy coming into this game on Saturday, 67-43. They are 1-6 on the road, and that is the worst road record of any team in the conference, but not by much, because the Lions on the road this year are 1-10. So you can tell that both Bluffton and the Mount are having a tough time on the road this season. The Mount leads the all-time season series, 28 wins against 22 defeats. That is after the Lions were defeated in Bluffton back on November the 30th by a final of 57-50. That was the first game of the conference season for both of these ball clubs. Bluffton, their problem, shooting. They're shooting just 38% from the field. They shoot 31% from three-point range. They've hit just 68% of their free throws, and they're grabbing just 32 rebounds per ball game. They're averaging 56.1 a game, and they're giving up 71.6 per game. So that's almost a difference of 15 points per game coming into this one. The Lions, on the other hand, are 6-13. They are 5-7 in the Heartland Conference. And here at the Harrington Center on the year, they are 5-2 at home at the Harrington Center. They are averaging 62.6 points per ball game, and they're giving up 65 points to the opposing teams. And they are coming in off of that loss at Rose Holman on Saturday, 67-57. The Lions are shooting 44% from the field, 34% from three-point range, 74% from the charity stripe, and they're grabbing 34 rebounds a game. But more importantly, they're averaging 62.6 points per ball game, and they are giving up 65 points in every outing so far this season. We had a chance to talk with the Lions head coach, Toby Kerrigan, before tonight's ball game.
Toby Kerrigan before tonight's ball game with Bluffton. Coach, the last ball game that we played up in Northwest Ohio against the Beavers, it was a 7-point loss. And as we've always talked about, Bluffton, when you get them on their home floor, they are extremely physical. And that game was about as physical a ball game as we've had to play this year. They don't do that quite as much on the road as what I've seen over the past 5 or 6 years. What's the difference between them, in your mind, between them at home and on the road? Anything?
Well, I think it's just like everybody. Everybody's a little more comfortable at home, just like we are. You know, with the team we have this year, we look a lot better at home than on the road. And sometimes that's just maturity and age and experience. And he's got some young guys he's playing right now. So, but they're going to play hard. They're going to play with a high level defensively, like Coach Neal's teams always do. And you know, he's got a freshman guard, Brady Wheeler, who's you know, doing a great job scoring the ball right now on everybody. So he was a problem for us the first time, and so we'll have to make sure we do a better job with him today.
Before I get into us, what made him such a tough handle against us up there?
Well, he can score at all three levels, but he can also get separation. He's not particularly big or tall, but he can get separation with a dribble, step back, side steps, and out dribbles. Like he's pretty crafty, and he just needs a little bit of separation, kind of shoots it high over his head. So even if you're there, he can still get it off. And up there, he was getting it off and making them.
There was about a 5 or 7 minute stretch that we had against him up there where he just took the ball game over, didn't he?
Yeah, for sure. I think we got it. You know, I think we got it to a one possession game in the second half, and I think he got an and one, and maybe made a three on us, like back to back. So, yeah, he doesn't play like a freshman. He doesn't have an attitude like a freshman. So he's gonna be a nice player in this league for a while.
Coach, Jack Kolar's missed the past few games because of the left elbow injury. What's his status for tonight?
Shoulder injury. I'm sorry.
Yeah. He's back. He's practiced the last 2 days. He was obviously happy to be back, and you know, didn't look like it bothered him at all. He's got a little brace on his shoulder, so he'll be out there tonight.
He's one of those kids, in my opinion, I thought we've missed him over the past 3 or 4 ball games.
Yeah, for sure. When you take a guy away from the perimeter that can make shots and that you have to stay out on defensively, that affects, you know, other parts of other guys' games. So, yeah, certainly having him back out there tonight will be nice for us.
Now, Turner, what's his status also? I'm assuming he's not playing tonight.
No, he's still out. He's still out, yeah, for the rest of this week.
Okay, and as far as Collinsworth is concerned, he had a little problem in practice yesterday.
Yeah, just got hit on the thumb a little bit, but he's good. He's going to have it taped up. He's ready to go.
How much do you think Bluffton's going to change their defensive philosophy with Collinsworth back in the – he missed the game up there. He's going to be in this one here tonight.
Yeah, I mean, most people have been doubling Luke in the post, and you know, they might double Dane after he scored 21 at Rose Holman on Saturday. So I wouldn't be surprised if they try to double down a little bit, especially if Luke gets going early on, you know. And so, obviously, having a guy out there like Jack who can shoot it, you know, we'll stretch their defense a little bit and hopefully be a little bit of an advantage for us.
Coach, talk about the offense and the way it has run over the past few games. We've had – it seems like 2 or 3 shot clock violations in each ball game. What has caused those? The defense or just us overpassing the basketball? In your mind, what are you seeing?
Well, I told our guys that doesn't bother me when the shot clock gets below 10. And obviously you don't want shot clock violations and have a turnover. But, you know, if we're trying to, you know, if we've thrown it in the post and thrown it out because we don't have a good look and we try to work and get it back in there, and I would rather have a shot clock violation than chuck up a bad shot, because we're not taking a forced shot. So I've told those guys that doesn't bother me when the shot clock runs down. You know, again, adding another scorer out there like Jack tonight should help that a little bit. But yes, the defense also has been key, and you know, we've been pounding the post. Our post guys have been pretty productive the last three or four games, and so a lot of doubling, a lot of extra passes have to be made, and so that's going to take some time off the clock. But I'm not concerned about, you know, sometimes we need to play at a little slower pace, and I'm all right with that.
Their coach, Guy Neal, retiring after 32 years at the helm up in Bluffton. Your thoughts about him and just his retirement?
Yeah, I mean, Coach Neal, he's been a staple in this league for a long time, and so we'll definitely miss not having him in the league. He's done such a great job. His teams are always prepared, always play hard, get after you defensively, and just play super physical, kind of old school basketball. And he is what I would consider to be old school. And so, but I love Coach Neal and what he's done, and he'll be missed for sure.
Good luck today.
Thank you.
At Mount St. Joseph University, our mission is to provide students with an affordable, world-class education in a safe, comfortable, private school setting. Nearly 100% of our incoming undergraduate students receive scholarships, grants, or financial aid. And with small class sizes and a 98% undergraduate career placement rate, the Mount leads the way in educational value and student success. Discover your potential. Discover the Mount at msj.edu/admissions.
It is basketball time here from the Harrington Center on the campus of Mount St. Joseph University. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to UltimateSportsTalk.com. I'm Dave Mitchell. Tonight, men's college basketball for you as the Lions will be entertaining the Bluffton Beavers. The Beavers come in with a record of 4-15 overall, and they are 2-11 in the Heartland Conference. Let's check out their starting lineups here this evening. Mike Stammen will be at one guard. He is a 5'11 junior, averaging 7.5 points per ball game. He will be wearing number 3 tonight. And in the backcourt with him will be Brady Wheeler. Wheeler, number 10, a 5'11 freshman, averaging 10.8 points per ball game. In the frontcourt, Ryan Rose, number 22, a 6'1 senior, averaging 1.2 points per ball game. And Marcus Bruns will be at the other forward, a 6'3 senior, averaging 2.5 points per game. He's number 24. In the middle, Connor Martin, a 6'6 sophomore, averaging just under 5 points per ball game. He is number 44 here tonight for the purple and gold. So it's Stammen, Wheeler, Rose, Bruns, and Martin for Guy Neal in his 32nd and final year as head coach here at Bluffton. 375 wins, 443 defeats. He is assisted by Bill Schwartz and Dennis Thompson. Now for the Mount St. Joseph University Lions, 6-13 overall, 5-7 in the Heartland Conference. They will start out at the forwards. Dane Gardner had 21 on Saturday. He is a 6'4 sophomore, averaging 8.3 a game. He's number 0. Jack Kolar back in the starting lineups here tonight. Kolar, a 6'2 senior, number 21, averaging just under 8 points per ball game. Luke Collinsworth will be in the middle tonight, folks. Big Luke playing with that sprained thumb. He's a 6'7 sophomore. He did not play against Bluffton in the first game. He's number 45. Evan Weehee will be at one guard. He's number 30. Weehee, a 6'2 sophomore, averaging 8 points a game. And also at the other guard will be Willard Cluxton, number 3, a 5'9 junior, averaging 2.1 a game. So it's Gardner, Kolar, Collinsworth, Weehee, and Cluxton for Toby Kerrigan, the head coach of the Lions in his 11th year, 139 wins against 150 defeats. He is assisted by Jalen Goodwin. Collinsworth in the center circle, set to go against Connor Martin. The ball is in the air, tip control to Bluffton, and we are underway here in Cincinnati. Bluffton in their dark purple uniforms with white numerals, trim, and lettering. Lions start out in the man-to-man defense as Bluffton passes it around the perimeter. They get it to Stauman near the scorer's table with 10 on the shot clock. Drives in against the Lions man-to-man and gets it off right side to Brady Wheeler. Spins top of the circle. Back over to Stauman. He's going to put up the left wing three-pointer off the iron. No good. Rebound taken down by Martin in the lane. Hook shot in the lane in front of Collinsworth. Nope. And Collinsworth got the defensive rebound. Into the front court come the Lions. They bring it up with Willard Cluxton against man-to-man of Bluffton again, and they play very physical. Spinning Gardner into the hole, put it up and in. Boy, he put a move on Bruns and got the first bucket of the ball game, and the Lions lead it at 2-0. Out front with the basketball, Rose. Rose gets it off to Stauman. Gets it now to Wheeler. Wheeler in the circle. Hooks a pass down into the right corner for a three-pointer by Rose. Got it. Rose has got his first three of the ball game, and Bluffton has taken a 3-2 lead here early. 18:40 to go in the first half. Tolar, good to see him back in the lineup tonight. Gets it off on the right-hand side to Weehee. Now between the circles to Gardner on the left wing. Kolar hooks a pass to Gardner, left baseline, down to the lane, double-teamed into the lane. He'll put it up, he'll got it, and he's fouled. Boy, Dane might have got away with a push-off down low, but nonetheless, he got the bucket, and the foul is going to be called on Bluffton's Marcus Bruns. That will be his first, and the first against Bluffton as a team. Gardner, 4 points. He'll go to the line looking for five, shooting 74% from the stripe, and he clanks that one off the front iron. And the rebound taken down by Bluffton. They get the ball up the floor on the left-hand side, Stauman. Stauman with the basketball on the left wing. Tried to get the pass over to Rose, but it was knocked out of bounds. Last touched by Rose, and the turnover gives it back to the Lions. First turnover of the ball game against either team here tonight. With it top of the circle, near the center circle is Collinsworth. Swings it down into the corner to Cluxton. Back to Collinsworth. Coming in from behind. Split the defense. Laid it up on the right side. Got it. Collinsworth with his first two. Lions have doubled it up on Bluffton 6-3. Stauman around a pick. Set out front by Martin. Goes down on the left baseline and Rose. And now back out front, Brady Wheeler. He's going to drive right baseline. Comes to a skidding stop underneath the bucket. Out front, Rose, now to Stauman. Stauman dumps it off underneath into the lane to Martin. He'll put up a hook shot, no good. Rebound taken up off the floor, stolen away by Bluffton, and a foul's going to be called on the mound. Collinsworth had his hands on the basketball, but couldn't hang on to it. And then the foul was called on Willard Cluxton. Willard his first, team's first. Going line left is going to be Cam Martin. Connor Martin, excuse me, he's a 6'6 sophomore, averaging 5 a game. Puts that one up and it's no good. Martin had 9 in the first game, came into this one averaging 4.8 a game. And he's shooting 53% from the stripe. Line left, second one, good. So Martin has his first points of the ball game, and Bluffton's going to put on some semi-pressure in the backcourt. Wheeler just trying to be a little bit of a pest to Cluxton as he brings it up. Gets it into the front court to Gardner. Now the center circle to Collinsworth down on the left-hand side inside the arc to Gardner. Spins to the baseline, pump fake, looking inside, put it up and in. Gardner with 6 in the ball game against Nevin Robson, who just snuck into the contest for Bluffton, and they get it off on the right side, Cam Rogers. Rogers did not play in that first game. Ball stolen away by Evan Weehee. Weehee will take it in. 1-on-3. Spins into the lane. Put it up too hard. Off the back iron. And the rebound taken down by Bluffton. Lions may have been better off waiting for a better shot than that. With it is Connor Martin. Martin between the circles. Off to Brady Wheeler. Pulls up 15-footer left baseline. Nope. Rebound taken down by Martin. One dribble into the lane. Can't find anyone. Throws it up with the left hand off the back iron. Nope. Jack Kolar got the rebound. Kolar gets it off to Cluxton. Into the front court across the timeline. It goes to Collinsworth on the left wing. Kolar. Kolar gets it off to Cluxton with 16:23 remaining to go in the half. Kolar top of the key to the right elbow with the dribble. Back outside Gardner on the left wing. Cluxton. Cluxton dribbles to the left elbow, kicks it back to Kolar, right of the circle for three, drilled it. Welcome back, Jack Kolar. Lions with an 11-4 lead, 16:09 left to go in this first half of action, and there's a timeout on the floor taken by Bluffton. That'll be their first, and it's a 30, which gives us an opportunity to take a look at the score going on up in Northwest Ohio with the women's basketball game, and of course a very, very important game here tonight for Mount St. Joseph, and with 3:16 left to go in the first quarter of action, the Lions are down to Bluffton, 10-7 up on the Beavers' home court. In college basketball here tonight, at they've just begun the second half, of action over at Xavier, and the Musketeers have a 39-35 win over, or not win, but lead over Providence. Now make that 41-35. Purdue is blowing out Penn State 44-31. And Florida, right now with 3 minutes to go in the half, leads Tennessee 22-21. 16:09 remaining here. After that timeout taken by Guy Neal, his first. Lions come back out onto the floor with the starters, Weehee, Kolar, Gardner, Collinsworth, and Cluxton. Lions are going to put full court pressure now on Bluffton, try to continue this stretch here of keeping Bluffton a little bit off an even keel. In the backcourt with the basketball is Robson. Now Robson gets it off to Stommen, back to Robson. Hands it off, Wheeler back out front, Stommen near the center circle. Switches to the right, goes to the left, back off on the left-hand side to Stommen, now to Rogers. Rogers back outside, and he goes over on the right-hand side too. Robson in the lane, left-hand shot, good. Nevin Robson with his first two, and Bluffton pulls within five at 11-6. 15.5 remaining to go in this first half of action. Top of the key, Collinsworth, one dribble, back outside to the left base, left sideline to Evan Weehee. Then he got it back to Collinsworth around a pick by Luke. Is Kolar. Kolar gave it up to Collinsworth, then back to Jack at the top of the key. Collinsworth bounce pass, left side of the lane by Collinsworth. Collinsworth got it knocked free, got it back, put it up off the glass, rim it in from 10. Collinsworth with four doesn't show that he's any worse for wear. With that sprained thumb, he's playing well. And the Lions right now lead it 13-6, Collinsworth with four. Stommen, line, lane, right of the lane, lays it up. Around the rim, won't go. Boy, there's a lid on that one, and the rebound taken down by Collinsworth. Gets it up the floor to Weehee into the front court. We're under 15 to go in the first half. Collinsworth swings it to the left-hand side to Kolar. Now it goes to Gardner. Gardner, left of the lane, spins into the lane with the left hand, spins to his right, lost the handle, got it back, put it up high off the glass, and in. Gardner's got eight, 15-6, Lions lead it here early in this ballgame, 14:20 to go in the first half. Stommen goes out top of the circle to J.D. Stokes, who just came into the ballgame. Now back to Stommen. Stommen drives the lane. He's going to throw it up way high off the backboard, no good. Fell to the floor, and the Lions got the rebound. Kolar, right wing three, around the rim and out, no good. Hit the backboard, came down into the hands of Wheeler. Top of the key, Rogers. Rogers with it on the right-hand side, goes to Stommen, now to Stokes. Stokes looking down low, now gets it to Rogers. Rogers pulls up from 17, just barely grazed the iron. Stokes tried to save it on the baseline, but it still went out of bounds, back to the mound. Menninger into the ball game, and Kratzer is into the contest. Also, Alex Totten, Weehee, Collinsworth, and Kolar will sit down. Menninger has started the last few games in the absence of Jack Kolar, and he did a very, very good job for the Lions. Totten in the front court now gets it off to Cluxton. Hands it off to Gardner. Top of the key, it goes to Totten. Bounce pass right of the lane to Kratzer. On the back door, tried to get it to Menninger, and a foul is going to be called on Matt Menninger. Menninger with his first. And that's just the team's second. Bringing it up the floor is Stommen for the Beavers. Stommen on the left-hand side, Brady Wheeler. Wheeler left elbow, kicks it over to Stokes, got the ball not free. Stokes lost it on the baseline, but saves it inbounds. Now ball loose on the floor, picked up by Wheeler, and a foul is going to be called on Cluxton. And Toby Kerrigan immediately wants to know how that could be a foul on Cluxton, but it was called that way, his second. And the Lions have to take Willard out and bring in Danny Austin. Inbounds pass, Bluffton gets it off to Wheeler on the right wing, Stommen. Stommen swings a pass down low to Stokes, pulls up from 15, right baseline, got it. Stokes had four in the first game, he's got two now. And with 12:50 left to go in the first half, Lions are now leading it by 7, 15-8. On the right side, Austin to the right of the lane, kicks it back outside, and it goes to Nate Kratzer. Kratzer looking back door, feeds it sideline left to Gardner, underneath to Kratzer. Kratzer into the right corner to Menninger with 6 on the clock, and it's knocked out of bounds by Bluffton, so it will stay with the Lions, and they're going to put it in play on the sideline down deep in the corner, a very difficult place to put it in from. Putting it in, Austin, right of the lane, Kratzer, 5-footer, right baseline, missed everything, overshot the bucket. Rebound taken down by Bluffton. They get it up the floor to Wheeler. Crossover dribble, left wing, off to Cam Rogers, and he lost it off his knee and out of bounds. So the Lions get the ball back on the turnover. And they will put the ball in play with Gardner. That is the third turnover of the ball game by Bluffton. In the lane, Kratzer, pump fake in the lane. Kicks it back outside to Gardner. Spins to his right, right of the lane. Drives inside, looking underneath, and he'll put it up and in. Boy, when he gets down that low, forget it. Gardner's got 10 in the ball game. Lions by 9 at 17-8. With it sideline right, goes down into the corner to Stommen. Back out front, Brady Wheeler. Wheeler, boy, he had 18 in the first game. He's been silent in this one. Wheeler underneath pass, and he came to a skidding stop and walk with the basketball. That'll be the fourth turnover of the ball game, and now we've got an official timeout. 11:42 left to go in the first half. It's now the Mount 17, Bluffton 8 on the Mount St. Joseph Radio Network.
What is power? It's loyalty to the game. Power inspires. Power unifies. Power never quits. Power makes the impossible possible in rising to the top. We are the Americans, and we are power.
11:42 left to go in this first half of action from the Harrington Center. Oh, we've got the band here. Lakota West boys basketball team from the high school is here tonight. Just a good crowd here at the Harrington Center for a very chilly Wednesday night. Lions will be on the road Saturday at Manchester. Game time will be at 1 o'clock, and it'll be a men's and women's doubleheader, and the second game will get underway at 3. In the women's game going on up at Bluffton right now as they head into the second quarter of play, Bluffton has a 4-point lead over the Lions, 16-12. Lions need a win to keep pace with Anderson for that third spot in the conference. They've actually got the tiebreaker against Anderson. Lions have the basketball after the timeout. They break the pressure by Bluffton to Menninger in the front court. Now to Collinsworth, double team from behind. Got the ball back after it was knocked loose. Ball loose still on the floor. Kratzer has it, and a reach-in foul is going to be called on Bluffton. That'll be on J.D. Stokes. His first, and that's just the second team foul against Bluffton here tonight with 11:23 to go in the first half. Inbounds pass made to Danny Austin. Cluxton off the floor now because he's got two personal fouls. Top of the circle, right of the lane. It goes to Collinsworth on the left wing. Menninger down into the left corner. Totten for three. Hit the front iron. Nope. Rebound saved. Inbounds by Menninger. He'll dribble it out and get it back off to Totten. Left wing. Collinsworth dumps it off underneath to Kratzer. Back out front, Totten. Left wing, Collinsworth. All alone, the three. Sputtered around. No good. Menninger had the rebound. Got it knocked free. And a foul is going to be called on the Lions. And that'll be on Matt Menninger. They're saying he kicked one of the Bluffton players. And now Dane Gardner will come in. And Menninger will have to leave the ballgame with those two personal fouls. 10:53 remaining. Weehee back in, Kolar back in. Now Cluxton, they're going to roll the dice and bring him back in with those two personals. Austin is out, Totten out, and Menninger out. So now Bluffton will bring it up, and the Lions will meet them right at the half-court stripe on the man-to-man. On the right side, Cam Rogers. Rogers, top of the circle. Looking underneath, can't find anyone. Now gets it off to Stammen. Bounce pass right baseline, Stokes from 15, no good. And the rebound taken down by Luke Collinsworth. Collinsworth gets it up the floor into the front court and off to Cluxton. Cluxton with the basketball on the right-hand side. Hands it off to Collinsworth. Now left of the circle to Kolar. Kicks it off to Weehee. Left wing three. No good. Missed it too hard. And the rebound taken down by Brady Wheeler. Wheeler brings it from right to left across the timeline. On the left-hand side to Ringer. Ringer, who just came into the ballgame for Bluffton. Hands it off sideline right. Wheeler with the basketball now out front to Stammen. Stammen crossover dribble left of the lane. It goes to Wheeler left of the circle. Behind the back dribble around a pick by Stokes. Pulls up from 16. Got it. And a foul is called on Evan Weehee. Boy, a touch foul down outside. Weehee picks up his first. That is the fourth against the Lions as a team. Wheeler, that's his first two, and let's see if this gets him started. He goes line right, puts it up and in. Wheeler now with three in the ball game, and the Lions have had their lead cut to seven at 17-10. 9:53 remaining to go in this first half. Inbounds pass made to Gardner, back to Cluxton, Weehee, and then back to Gardner. On the right wing, Kolar for three. Got it. Jack's got six, evening what he had at Bluffton back on the 30th of November, and it's 20-11. The Lions lead it by nine. Left corner, Ringer couldn't find the handle of the basketball, but it went right into the hands of Wheeler. Crossover dribble left wing, step back, long three, no good. Rebound chased into the corner. Weehee let it go, and Wheeler saved it inbounds and then threw it off one of the Mount players. Now the officials are saying it belongs to Bluffton. Boy, did they miss that call. Weehee is the one that actually never touched the ball, and Bluffton gets it back. Fall away. 15-footer by Ringer, no good. Weehee got the rebound, gets it off to Cluxton. Into the front court from left to right. Back over to Weehee, between the circles to Collinsworth. Left side, now to Kolar, back to Cluxton. Cluxton, bounce pass, got the ball kicked away, and it's stolen away by Bluffton. Brings it up the floor, Stammen with it on the left side of the front court. Right-hand dribble, now to Ringer. Now Rogers, excuse me. Rogers, left elbow, dribbles back over to the right elbow with a right-hand dribble. Out front, Stammen. 17 on the shot clock. Bluffton with the basketball. Stammen around a pick by Stokes, right of the lane. Now backs it out to the wing. Stammen still with the dribble, steps back. Long three, nope. Hit the backboard, went right over the top of the backboard and out of bounds. And that'll give it back to the Lions. 8:34 remaining. 20-11. Lions now by nine. With it is Kolar in the backcourt and gets it off to Willard Cluxton. Cluxton near the timeline, right in front of Guy Neal near the Bluffton bench. Hands it off to Gardner. Weehee bounce pass to Collinsworth. Left of the circle to Weehee around a pick by Luke on the right wing, Collinsworth. Now to Cluxton, top of the key, back to Collinsworth, top of the circle. Got the ball knocked away, but Collinsworth got it back. Cluxton kicks it off on the right-hand side to Kolar for a long three at the buzzer, wouldn't go. Rebound taken down, Wheeler all the way to the hole, laid it up and in. That's five in the ball game by Wheeler in the last minute and a half, and the Lions are down by seven, 20-13. 7:45 left to go on the left-hand side. Gardner. Gardner with it. Right-hand side, Cluxton. Now bounce pass goes to Gardner. Right of the lane, down near the baseline. Now backs it up near the low block, down low. Kicks it back outside, and an offensive foul is going to be called on Dane Gardner. Well, I got to be honest. I have never seen a worse official in the league than that one. They won't give us the names of the officials heading into ball games, but we've seen this guy about three times this year, and there has not been a worse official in the Heartland than that one. 7:32 remaining. Timeout on the floor. It's now the Mount 20 and Bluffton 13 on the Mount St. Joseph Radio Network.
Hello. Yes, can I ask a few questions about the apartment on Park Street?
What was your name?
My name is Juan Hernandez.
It's been rented.
Oh, it's gone. Hello, my name is Sanjay Kumar. I am calling about the apartment on Park Street.
It's not available.
Not available?
Hello, my name is Tyrone Washington. I'm calling about the apartment on Park Street.
Just been rented.
Hello, I am Chen Lin.
My name is Khalid Bin Ali.
I'm Tuan Vo.
Hello, my name is Moshe Goldberg. I use a wheelchair.
It's gone. Not available.
All right. Thank you.
Yes, hello, my name is Graham Wellington. I'm calling about the apartment for rent on Park Street. Is that still available?
Yes, it is.
What is?
Yes.
Really?
Housing discrimination is illegal. If you think you've been a victim because of your race, color, national origin, sex, religion, disability, or family status, call us. Fair housing. It's not an option. It's the law.
6:36 remaining up in Bluffton and in the women's game. And Bluffton leading 22-16 so far over Mount St. Joseph. Here with 7:32 remaining in the half, the Mount leads by 7, 20-13. Lions have Kolar, Cluxton, Weehee, Gardner, and Collinsworth on the floor. Ringer is still in the ballgame, Miguel Ringer, in the backcourt, along with Stammen, Stokes, Rogers, and Wheeler. With it now, left of the circle, Rogers inside the arc. Now back out front to Stammen. Stammen near the center circle. Stammen with a left-hand dribble off to Wheeler on the left side. Wheeler looking for a pick, around a pick by Stokes, stops on the left wing. Now goes back out front, Stammen, top of the key. Crossover dribble, left of the circle, on the right side, Rogers. He's going to drive in against Kolar. Stops, pops a five-footer, got it. Cam Rogers, his first two. Lions lead it by five again at 20-15. This has been one of those defensive struggles that Bluffton just loves to play. With it right of the lane, it goes to Collinsworth, backs in against Stokes, put it up, no, but a foul on J.D. Stokes. That will be his first, and it leads Bluffton to their third foul here in the first half. 6:42 remaining. Connor Martin will come in right after this first free throw by Luke Collinsworth. He's got four. Came in shooting 79%, hit the front iron, bounced high, and fell in. Luke with five, now Martin in, and leaving is Stokes. Martin checks into the ball game with just a point, had nine in the first one. Collinsworth didn't play in the first one. That's another line drive shot that he hits nothing but net. Collinsworth with six. Lions now lead it 22-15. Into the front court. Bluffton's Wheeler will bring it up inside the center circle, and the big Mount St. Joseph Lion right there hands it off on the right side to Cam Rogers. Rogers drives in right of the lane, now kicks it back outside to Wheeler. Spins to his left, throws up a floater from baseline right from 10, no. And the rebound taken down by Dan Gardner. Gardner with his third rebound of the night on the left wing, Kolar. Kolar now spins it back out front, gets it off to Weehee with 6:05 remaining to go in the half. Off to Collinsworth, on the left wing goes to Kolar, back to Collinsworth, laid it up on the left side, got it to go. Collinsworth with eight, Lions by nine again at 24-15. We're under 6 minutes remaining. On the right side, Wheeler. Wheeler down to the right baseline, now to the block. Top of the key, Martin. Martin inside the lane, spins into the lane. Left-hand shot put off the glass. No. Rebound bounced off the floor. Gardner picked it up. Gardner leading the break. It's three on two all the way to the hole. The right hand got it to go. Gardner over the last few games has learned how to use that right hand, and he has got 12 in the ball game, and the Lions lead at 26-15. With it, Ringer, now off to Wheeler, left side, Stammen. Stammen to the line. Kicks it back outside to Ringer, and he ran right over the top of Dane Gardner and gets called for the offensive foul. Ringer, with no regard for life or limb, just ran right over the top of Dane Gardner. And on Ringer, that is his first. And that's the fourth against Bluffton as a team. They will put on full court 2-2-1, full court pressure. Inbounds pass made to Gardner for the Lions in the backcourt. Now back to Cluxton. Cluxton will bring it across the timeline. Right wing Leahy, he's going to launch it from right side. No good. And the rebound taken down on the play by Bluffton. They get the ball up the floor on the right-hand side. And it goes off to Jalen Cromwell. Now to Wheeler. Wheeler back out front. Hands it off to Ringer. Ringer with a left-hand dribble, top of the key. Spins it back outside and gets it off to Wheeler, sideline right. Now back underneath on the outside, and it goes to Ringer. Ringer gets a nice pass underneath to Stahman, who laid it up and in. Stahman, his first two, and it's a 26-17 Mount lead. 4.5 remaining to go in the half. Cluxton will bring it up, top of the circle, and he'll be fouled by Wheeler. And Wheeler took the brunt of that one. Matt Menninger will come in for the Lions, and leaving will be Evan Weehe. 4:27 left. And putting into play will be the Lions. Just to the left of the Bluffton bench on this side. And they inbound the basketball. The Cluxton dribbles to the left side of the floor. Got it underneath the Collinsworth, but he bobbled it and stolen away by Bluffton. Stahman up the right side. Pulls up from 15 off the back iron. Nope. Rebound. Gardner tipped it over to Cluxton. Up on the left-hand side to Kolar. Kolar behind the back dribble. Stops. Dumps it off underneath to Collinsworth. Collinsworth back outside. Gardner over Cluxton on the right wing. Kolar for three. No, off the backside. And it gets taken down off the rebound by Bluffton. Stahman gets it into the front court. And it goes to Cam Rogers. He's going to drive the lane. Lost the handle. Picked off the floor by Cluxton. And then he tried to throw a pass up the floor to Kolar. And it got knocked free and out of bounds. There's an official timeout on the floor. 3:45 left to go in this first half of action from the Harrington Center. It's now the Mount 26 and Bluffton 17 on the Mount St. Joseph Radio Network.
Where are you headed? Where would you like to go? New heights, right? That's why you're going to college in the first place. At Mount St. Joseph University, we integrate academic excellence, real-world experience, and individual attention so that you can go further than you ever thought possible. In fact, over 96% of our graduates over the past 3 years were employed or pursuing graduate studies within 6 months of graduation. Are you ready to climb higher? Begin your ascent at msj.edu.
You're a Lions fan. Own it. And we are the radio home of Mount St. Joseph Lions Sports, ultimatesportstalk.com. Football, basketball, wrestling, volleyball, softball, baseball. We are Cincinnati's sports website and also the home of the Ohio Baseball Weekly Show every Monday night during the baseball season. We are the home of the Mount St. Joseph Lions, ultimatesportstalk.com.
3 minutes, 45 seconds left to go in this first half of action. And at halftime, have we got an interesting halftime show for you tonight. We have absolutely nothing planned. It's going to be me talking about anything I want to talk about over the 15-minute halftime show. So stick around for that. I'll either run out of gas and take a nap, or we'll just talk about anything in the world of sports. 26-17. One of the things we'll talk about is my feeling about Tom Brady retiring today. I don't think he's retired. 26-17, Lions lead it by 7. And the women, 2:43 left to go in the half. They're down by 3, 26-23. Top of the key, Menninger. On the left wing, it goes to Kolar. Dribbles down to the left baseline. Out top side to Menninger. One dribble to the left elbow. Back out to Austin. Top side, it goes to Kratzer. Kratzer looked back door, now gets it on the left wing to Kolar, back underneath to Kratzer on the low block, into the lane, up and under. Now he puts up a right-hand hook shot, blocked out of the air. Nice defense by Cam Rogers for Bluffton. Check that. That was not Cam Rogers, that was Jalen Cromwell, excuse me. With it on the left-hand side. Now for Bluffton is Rose, Rose gets it back outside to Stahman, over to Wheeler, to Stahman right corner. Stahman trying to back Austin down into the lane, gets it back outside to Bruns. Bruns over on the right-hand side to Rose for the top of the key three, got it. Rose has got six in the ball game, and don't look now, but Bluffton's down by six, 26-22, 40 to go in this first half. Bringing it up is Austin in the backcourt against that 2-2-1. Right wing all alone, Kolar for three, rattled it home. Jack, on his return game, has got nine on three threes, and it's 29-20, Lions leading it by nine. Between the circles, Bruns gets it on the left-hand side to Stahman, top of the key. On the left wing, Bruns again. Dribbles it near the key and kicks it outside to Wheeler, sideline right. Top side, Cromwell, now back outside to Rose. He's going to launch it from three again. Got it again. Rose has got nine on three threes. And again, that full court pressure with the Lions leading it by six, 29-23. Coming the other way, Austin gets it off on the right side. Menninger back to Austin. And a foul away from the ball is called by the underneath official. And that's going to be against Bluffton. And it looks like it'll be against Cromwell. Cromwell picks up his first, and that is the sixth against Bluffton as a team. Austin will put it in play, does to Kolar. Kolar gets it out, top of the circle, to Kratzer. Kratzer looking for a cutter underneath, hands it off to Menninger, right wing Kolar, top of the key, Menninger down to the left wing, gets it off to Austin, five on the shot clock, Kratzer. Left wing looks, gets it off to Austin, and it went right through his hands and off the official and out of bounds for the turnover. Now Collinsworth will come in and Cluxton will come in. Kratzer will leave, so will Austin, and Totten is into the ball game, and also sitting down will be Menninger. Bluffton has committed six turnovers in this ball game, leading to 4 points for the Mount. Five turnovers in the game for the Mount, leading to 4 points also for Bluffton. Top of the key, Rose on the left-hand side, Stahman, hands it off Wheeler. Wheeler with the left-hand dribble on the left-hand side. It goes to Stahman, drop step into the lane, put it up, and it is good off the glass, and he was fouled. Bucket's gonna count, and that foul will be on Cluxton, and immediately that's three. And Willard will leave the ball game with those three personal fouls. And that puts the Lions at 16 fouls. And going line left, shooting for the three-point play is Stahman. Put it up and in. Stahman now has five, and it's 29-26. Bluffton has cut it to three. Again, 2-2-1 full court pressure. Gardner's going to break it himself. Comes to a jump stop at the top of the key to Austin. Puts it up from 18, no good. Rebound Stahman, up the floor with under a minute to go. Gets it up the floor to Rose, left wing Stahman. Stahman looking down low, kicks it off into the corner to Wheeler for three, around the rim and in, and we're tied. Boy, just like that, full court pressure, couple of turnovers and three-point plays, and the Lions now find themselves tied at 29. Gardner with 34 seconds to go in the half. Off to Austin, lays it up and in. Boy, nice aggressive move by Danny Austin to give the Lions the lead again at 31-29. No shot clock, it is off. And at the center circle, now is Stahman. Bluffton will hold it for the last shot. On the right side it goes to Wheeler, now Rose, bounce pass, 9 seconds to go to Stahman. Back out to Rose, top of the circle, three, missed everything out of bounds, and the Lions will have the basketball back in the backcourt with 3.8 left to go, and it's a spot out. Austin will put it in play, does to Kolar. Kolar, 2 seconds, 1 second. He's gonna throw it up at the buzzer. It won't count if it goes, and it won't. And that is the end of the first half of play. And after we've played one, here at the Harrington Center in Cincinnati, Ohio, it's the Mount St. Joseph Lions, 31, and the Bluffton Beavers, 29. At halftime in the women's game, it is 31-23, Bluffton on top. Now make it 31-25, Bluffton on top in the women's game going on up in Bluffton. But here in the men's game, it's the Mount 31, the Beavers 29 on the Mount St. Joseph Radio Network.
Changing lives is what great teachers do. Mount St. Joseph University's Reading Science program that uses highly effective research-based methods improved my students' lives and helped me climb higher in my career. Begin your ascent at msj.edu/read.
Dayton Children's cares about the health of your children. Hi, I'm Kirk Herbstreit. Growing up in Centerville, my parents taught me the importance of being healthy, and now I'm teaching my kids. Childhood obesity is on the rise, but there are small steps that we could take to fight it. Turn off video games and go outside, ride bikes, go to the park, or learn a new dance. Parents, once we get moving, our kids will follow.
Yeah! Get moving!
Dayton Children's, experts you trust, caring for the children you love.
Take your game to new heights at Mount St. Joseph University with 23 athletic teams and cutting-edge facility. We are the NCAA Division III University in Greater Cincinnati. Climb higher at www.msj.edu.
Odyssey now has hundreds of new exclusive music stations for you to discover your new summer soundtrack.
Get moving with worthy workouts for a cardio sesh fueled by today's top artists.
Hang in with your crew, throw it back with Picnic Party for old school jams for your cookout.
Or sail away with Odyssey's new yacht rock station, Jugger Yacht.
For summer barbecues, road trips,
or relaxing poolside.
Hundreds of new exclusive stations, plus all your favorite local radio stations and podcasts. It's all on Odyssey.
Well, the Lions are leading this one here at the Harrington Center by a score of 31-29 here at the end of the first half of action. The Lions, well, they had the lead, their biggest lead of the ball game, with 5 minutes to go in the first half, and they led it by 11, 26-15. And after that, boy, Bluffton put on a show. They outscored the Lions 14-5. And they're down by only two now at halftime, talking to their head coach, Guy Neal, by a two-point margin of 31-29. And the women's game going on up in Bluffton. Well, at halftime, your score is Bluffton 31 and the Mount 25 in that ball game. And just giving you an idea of who is leading the way for both teams in scoring tonight for the Lions. They are being led by Anaya Murphy. Boy, is she really leading this team down the stretch, trying to pick up that third seed in the tournament. Now, if you win that third seed, the reason it's so important is you host a game. Even if you win the fourth seed, you host a game, because it'll be 3 against 6 and 4 against 5. But that third seed is so important because you want to make sure that you're going to host a game in the tournament. So Anaya Murphy with 10 points. She's the only girl in double figures for the Lions. Maddie Drummond has got 4 points in the ballgame for the Lions. Then Carly Mills, 3. Morgan Jenkins, Carly Dalton, Shelby Turner, and Sienna Slaughter each have 4. Annabelle Williams, Chloe Jansen, and Emily Elliott have all played but have not scored. I can tell you without even watching the game, the Lions need to get scoring out of Chloe Jansen if they hope to win that game up in Northwest Ohio. For Bluffton in the ballgame, they've got one girl in double figures also, and that's Morgan Smith with 11. And then Kayla Priggy has 8 in the ballgame. Kyla Columber has 4 to be the third leading scorer for Bluffton in the first half of action. When I come back, we're going to take a look at the Division III Top 25 college basketball rankings after this.
Do you want to grow as a leader? Mount St. Joseph University offers a flexible master's degree in organizational leadership. Classes meet about one Saturday a month. Climb higher and become the leader you were meant to be. Begin your ascent at msj.edu/msol.
I was in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean when it happened. There was a sudden jolt and our submarine crashed on the seafloor. We were in total darkness.
That's Dr. Dejana Figueroa, a marine biologist and STEM teacher, talking about a deep sea dive she'll never forget.
It's funny, when I was a kid, I was afraid of the ocean, and there I was, 2 miles below the surface. But as a scientist, you prepare for that. Using our training and a little creativity, we fixed the sub and finished our experiments. The dive was just too important. Every dive gives us glimpses at things few people ever get to see. Glowing creatures, fiery undersea volcanoes. When we got back to the surface, I kissed the ground and called my mom, of course. But you know what? I wouldn't trade that dive for anything.
Dr. Figueroa uses her passion for STEM to discover new things and make the world a better place. She can STEM, so can you. Check out She Can STEM for more stories and inspiration. A message from the Ad Council.
Lions are on top of this one at halftime, 31-29. They did have a lead of 15 in the first half, but it has dwindled down to 2 in the ball game. The top 25 men's and women's basketball rankings have come out for this week around Division III. St. Joseph out of Connecticut is leading the way for the men, with Randolph Macon number 2, Middlebury 3, Christopher Newport 4, and Mount Union from over in Alliance is the number 5 team in the country. John Carroll came in ranked at number 7, and at number 22 is Trine. There were a couple of teams down in the lower bracket that did receive some votes. One was Case Western Reserve up in Cleveland. They reserved some votes, and Worcester, who was actually beaten by Oberlin last week. The Yeomen beat Worcester, and that's Jalen Goodwin's. Jalen Goodwin graduated from the College of Worcester and was an assistant at Oberlin. And Oberlin defeated Worcester last week. It's the first time they had beaten Worcester in basketball, and I'm not joking, folks, since 1968. Bobby Kennedy was assassinated that year. Martin Luther King was assassinated. That was the year that Joe Namath guaranteed the Super Bowl victory, albeit in 1969. Nonetheless, that is a long, long time ago. I'm not going to date myself and tell you how old I was at the time. But, yeah, Oberlin finally defeated the College of Worcester. Now in women's top 25 college basketball, Trinity is on top of the women's rankings. But Transylvania is right there at number 2. Christopher Newport, 3. Scranton, 4. And Smith, 5. Trine is at number 12. Then comes Ohio Northern, 13. And Baldwin-Wallace, 14 in the top 25 women's Division III college basketball rankings. That's a look at the rankings right now. And as we take a look at some Division I college basketball scores, Providence trying to pull the upset here in Cincinnati. They are leading Xavier 66-65 with 5:45 remaining to go in that one. Purdue is on top of Penn State, 73-56. Tennessee, number 2 in the country, losing to Florida in Florida with 16 minutes to go. A lot of time there left. 34-30. Auburn trying to bounce back. They're beating Georgia 52-34. And there will be some other games starting up later on tonight. 31-29. The Mount leads it here at the half. I'm Dave Mitchell. When we come back, we'll take a look at the first half stats right after this.
Hi. This is Morgan Freeman. Has anyone ever said, you're the picture of health? You look healthy, you feel fine, but that may not be the full picture. Colorectal cancer is the second leading cancer killer of men and women over 50. Since it doesn't always cause symptoms, you may not know you have it. The only way to know is by getting screened. Screening can find precancerous polyps so they can be removed before they turn into cancer. This is one cancer you can prevent. Plus, screening can find colorectal cancer at an early stage when the chance for a full recovery is very high. Talk with your doctor and get tested for colorectal cancer. Medicare and many insurance plans help pay for screening. Get screened. Make sure you are the picture of health.
A message from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. What do you wish for? A nice life? Nice things? Or do you wish for something more? A sense of purpose? Do you wish to discover a cure? To write code that cracks an unsolvable question? To further our exploration into space? Or to invent something that changes everything right here on Earth? Well, if that's your wish, make yourself ready. Because when you look back,
you'll see that you didn't just make wishes. You realize them.
It is halftime here at the Harrington Center. I'm Dave Mitchell. And the Lions are leading this one at the half, 31-29. While we've got an opportunity, I want to go over the last part of the schedule for the Lion men. Right now, in the standings, they are literally two games behind of Rosehoman and Transylvania in the men's standings. The top six get into the tournament, and right now the Lions at 5-7 are two games behind Rose and Transy at 7-5. After tonight, the Lions are going to have four games left to go on the year, and they will have be at Manchester on Saturday. Then they play three games here at home, Transylvania, Earlham, and Franklin, and then they go to Hanover for the last game of the year on February 17th. So in order to have a shot at what's going on here, not only do they have to win tonight, they're going to need to beat Manchester and then sweep the games that are going on, those three home games, February 8th, 11th, and 14th against Transy, Earlham, and Franklin. And if they can do that, that Hanover game, the last game of the year on the 17th, which is a Friday night, would probably be a play-in game for the Lions. They would really need to win that game heading in. So that's kind of the mountain that the Mount men are facing to try to get into the tournament here at the end of the year. Leading the way in scoring for tonight for the Mount in 19 minutes, Dane Gardner. He's got 12 points. Matter of fact, only four players have scored for the Lions here tonight. Gardner, 6 of 6 from the field, but he's missed a free throw. 3 rebounds in the ballgame, 2 assists. 9 points tonight for Jack Kolar on 3 three-pointers. 8 points for Luke Collinsworth on 3 of 4 from the field, 2 of 2 from the line, and 2 points for Danny Austin on a lay-in in the ballgame. Lions shooting, well, they were 13 of 24 from the field for 54% in the first half, 3 of 11 from 3 for 27%, and 2 of 3 from the line for 67% in the ballgame. Leading the way for Bluffton, they've got nobody in double figures, but they've got 7 players that have scored. Ryan Rose leads the way with 9 points on 3 three-pointers and 4 attempts. Wheeler with 8 points here tonight on 3 of 7 from the field, and he is 1 of 1 from the line, plus 3 rebounds in 19 minutes of play for the freshman. 5 points to Stammen on 2 of 7 from the field. 2 points each for Robson, Rogers, and Stokes, and 1 point going to Connor Martin in the ballgame. 6 turnovers for Bluffton, 5 turnovers for the Lions, leading to 7 points for Bluffton. And off the turnovers for Bluffton, that has led to 4 points for the Lions here in the first half of play. 31-29, the Mount leads it by 2. Second half action coming up next on the Mount St. Joseph Radio Network.
¿A dónde te diriges? ¿Dónde te gustaría ir? Nuevas cumbres, ¿verdad? Es por eso que vas a ir a la universidad en primer lugar. En Mount St. Joseph University integramos la excelencia académica, la experiencia del mundo real y la atención individual para que puedas llegar más lejos de lo que tú creías posible. De hecho, más del 96% de nuestros graduados en los últimos 3 años estaban empleados o cursaban estudios de posgrado dentro de 6 meses posteriores a la graduación. ¿Estás listo para subir más alto? Comienza tu ascenso en mcj.edu.
Odyssey now has hundreds of new exclusive music stations for you to discover your new summer soundtrack.
Get moving with worthy workouts for a cardio sesh fueled by today's top artists.
Hang in with your crew? Throw it back with Picnic Party for old school jams for your cookout.
Or sail away with Odyssey's new yacht rock station, Jugger Yacht.
For summer barbecues, road trips,
or relaxing poolside.
Hundreds of new exclusive stations, plus all your favorite local radio stations and podcasts. It's all on Odyssey.
Lions are leading at 31-29 here in the men's game. And in the women's game up in Northwest Ohio, let's take a look at that score. They should be just about getting underway in the second half also, and it's 31-25. Bluffton leading that at halftime. A quick check at the Xavier game. Xavier losing to Providence by 170-69 on their home floor. 2:29 left to go in that one. No score from the Cincinnati game because it hasn't begun, and Florida is upsetting on their home floor. Number 2 Tennessee with 14:02 left to go, 36-33. Lions have the basketball. Weehe, Kolar, Cluxton, Gardner, and Collinsworth out on the floor for the dark gray and blue for the Mount St. Joseph Lions. Bluffton starts out in a man-to-man defense, and taking it on the left-hand side is Gardner, trying to spin in on the left-hand side against Bruns. Gardner still with the dribble into the lane, put it up with the right hand around the rim and fell. Gardner begins where he left off. He's got 14, and the Lions lead it now by 4, 33-29. When Gardner gets into that scoring mode, he's going to go for it. With it on the left-hand side, Wheeler, top of the key, to the line, got the ball knocked free. Wheeler knocked it away again, but got it back. Out front, Stommen on the left-hand side. Bruns, long three, drilled it. Marcus Bruns with his first bucket of the night. He's got three. And it's 33-32 as Cluxton, who's playing with three personal fouls, remember that, gets the ball off to Gardner. Now to Weehe, top of the circle, right side, Cluxton. Cluxton jabs right, goes left, gets it down underneath to Collinsworth, laid it up around the rim, it'll go, and he's fouled. Wheeler reached in and grabbed him on the arm, but Collinsworth still strong, put it up and in, and the first foul of the ball game called against Brady Wheeler. His first, team's first. 10 in the ball game for Collinsworth. He's 2 for 2 from the stripe, and he'll go line left trying to complete the old-fashioned three-point play. And he put it in. That's 11. We've played 1 minute, 3 seconds. And the Lions lead it by 4 again, 36-32. Into the front court, Stommen gets it off to Wheeler. Wheeler had 18 in the first game, but he has not shown any signs of that here in this one so far. Top of the key, Stokes. Stokes with the basketball on the right side. Got knocked free, and a foul is going to be called on Dane Gardner. .18-37 left to go in the ball game. 36-32 here from the Harrington Center. Inbounds pass, foul called by the outside official away from the ball, and that again is on Dane Gardner, and that'll be his third personal foul. Gardner just bang, 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 picked up two fouls immediately, and Bluffton will have the basketball back underneath their own bucket. Two against the Lions here in the half. With the basketball, left of the circle on the right-hand side. Goes underneath to Stommen, now to Stokes. Stokes with it, kicks it back outside. Rose on the right side, 8 on the clock, now to Stommen, right of the circle for the three. Back iron, nope. Rebound, Weehe tipped it over to Kolar. Gets it off to Cluxton, and he'll bring it up with 18:15 to go in the ballgame. Gets it off to Menninger between the circles, who came in for Gardner. Left of the lane, the Collinsworth spins to the baseline, back into the lane with the spinning right-hand hook shot. Got it. That's 13 in the ballgame for Big Luke, 38-32. Lions by 6. With the basketball on the left-hand side, Stokes. Stokes with it. Gets it back over on the right-hand side. To Stommen, now baseline right, Stokes from 12, got it. Stokes with 12. And with 17:35 to go, it is 38-34. Lions with the 4-point lead into the front court. On the right-hand side is Collinsworth. He drives the lane, throws it up too hard, got his own rebound, put it back up, and he's going to be fouled. So Collinsworth is going to go line left. And it will be Collinsworth going line left. Collinsworth on the night has got 13 points, and he put that one up and in. Now he has 14. He's had two consecutive games of 20 points or more. As he goes line left. Line left, Collinsworth eyes it, dips, shoots around the rim and fell. So Luke has got 15 in the ballgame. And the Lions are up again by 6 at 40-34. 40-34, Lions lead it. Collinsworth with 15 up on the right-hand side. Stauman gets it back out to Rose. Looked like he walked, but no call. Back over to Wheeler. Wheeler drives right of the lane. Kicks it off to Stauman. Right of the circle, Wheeler for the three. Missed it. Just grazed the front iron and out of bounds. Back to the Lions. 40-34, Guy Neal in his last year of coaching, approving of that shot. But it just barely grazed the rim. Cluxton to Weehe across the timeline. Weehe sideline right, 16:45 left to go in the game. Off to Menninger. Gets it on the left side. Kolar, and he threw it by him, let him out of bounds, and out of bounds. That'll be the sixth turnover of the game against the Lions, their first here in the second half. Bringing it up, Bluffton from left to right. They get it on the left-hand side now to Stauman, around a pick by Ringer. Stauman, right of the lane, down to the low block, stops, spins back outside to Wheeler. Wheeler down to the baseline against Weehe. He'll force it up, nope. Rebound taken down off the back iron by Collinsworth. Up the floor, Cluxton. On the right wing, Kolar. He'll spin to his left, throw it up from three, no good. And the rebound taken down by Bluffton. They get it up to Wheeler. Wheeler all the way to the hole, down to the baseline, around Collinsworth. Blocked the reverse layup shot. Pulled out of the air, and Cluxton will bring it up. Nice play defensively by Collinsworth after it looked like he'd been beat. With it, Cluxton on the right side. Cluxton with the basketball, back out front. Collinsworth from three, got it! Collinsworth needs to play with a sprained thumb more often. He's got 18, and the Lions lead it by 9 again, 43-34. With it, Wheeler, top of the circle. Right side, Rose, over to Stauman, right of the lane to Ringer. Ringer dropping down low to Jalen. Now Jalen, put it up, prompted, put it up, no good. And the rebound taken down. Cromwell put that shot up, no good, and the Lions got it back. With it is Cluxton. Cluxton drives right baseline, around underneath the bucket. Back to Weehe, top of the key. Collinsworth again for three, got it again! He's got 21, timeout, Guy Neal and the Beavers with 15:03 left to go in the ballgame. Your score, it's the Mount 46, the Beavers 34 on the Mount St. Joseph Radio Network.
Where are you headed? Where would you like to go? New heights, right? That's why you're going to college in the first place. At Mount St. Joseph University, we integrate academic excellence, real-world experience, and individual attention so that you can go further than you ever thought possible. In fact, over 96% of our graduates over the past 3 years were employed or pursuing graduate studies within 6 months of graduation. Are you ready to climb higher? Begin your ascent at msj.edu.
Dayton Children's cares about the health of your children. Hi, I'm Kirk Herbstreit. Growing up in Centerville, my parents taught me the importance of being healthy, and now I'm teaching my kids. Childhood obesity is on the rise, but there are small steps that we could take to fight it. Turn off video games and go outside, ride bikes, go to the park, or learn a new dance. Parents, once we get moving, our kids will follow.
Yeah! Get moving!
Dayton Children's, experts you trust, caring for the children you love.
Well, Chuck Murray pulling double duty tonight, taking care of this one here, but also watching the Xavier game at the Cintas Center. And right now, with 37 seconds to go in that one, they are all tied up at 76 with Providence. Tennessee has battled back. They've got a three-point lead over Florida, 41-38. Here, the Mount is taken. A 12-point lead at 46-34, and up in Bluffton, it is now the Mount 39, Bluffton 37, with 4:32 remaining to go in the third quarter. Here we go, Bluffton with the basketball. After the timeout, they'll have two left. On the left side, Wheeler put it up from 15, short, and the rebound taken down by Danny Austin. Austin will bring it across the timeline, freshman against freshman. Austin got the ball stripped, stolen away. Up the floor, it goes all the way in for the layup, up and in by Robson. Robson's got four, he's back into the ballgame. It's a 10-point lead, 2-2-1. Full court pressure put on by Bluffton, but the Lions break it. Right baseline, Collinsworth. Heat check shot from the right corner. Put it up, no good. It'll go out of bounds out off of the Lions, and it'll go right back to Bluffton. 14:26 left to go, and the official timeout here has hit the floor. 14:26 left to go in the ballgame. Your score, it's the Mount 46, Bluffton 36 on the Mount St. Joseph Radio Network.
You want to advance your career through education, but you have a busy family and work schedule. Mount St. Joseph can help. The Mount's School of Business offers an MBA program on Saturday mornings where you can earn your master's degree in 2 years. Courses are led by faculty who are experts in their areas and taken one at a time, and the GMAT is not required for admission. Classes every Saturday can make a huge difference in your life and your career. Learn more about the Saturday MBA program. Visit msj.edu/MBA.
Take your game to new heights at Mount St. Joseph University. With 23 athletic teams and cutting-edge facilities, we are the NCAA Division III university in Greater Cincinnati. Learn more at msjlions.com.
Well, a public service announcement. The baseball and softball teams have officially started practice here at Mount St. Joseph University. And the week of March 12th through the 18th, Chris Morris, Blake Watson, Chuck Murray, and I will all be in Florida to bring you games in softball and baseball. Should have two games a day, sometimes three, throughout that week down in Florida. We're going to have a fun time. Hope you join us not only here on Ultimate Sports Talk, but also on WDTZ, LPFM Radio. Should be a lot of fun down there. It should be a very promising season for both the baseball and softball teams. With it the other way, Bluffton. They're going to lay it up around the rim and out of the rim, and it's no good. Put up by Stahman. Rebound taken down by the Mount. Austin hands it off to Totten. Now back out front. Kolar. Bounce pass that goes to Collinsworth. Collinsworth top of the circle. Now gets it back over to Totten. Totten with the left side. Bounce pass underneath. Knocked free and out of bounds on the play by Martin. Now checking into the ballgame, Cam Rogers. And leaving is Rose. Rogers, 2 points in the ball game. Rose comes in with nine, but he's scoreless here in the half. Totten left of the circle, long three all alone, no good. And a long rebound taken down near the corner by Rogers. Gets it up the floor to Wheeler on the left-hand side. It goes to Robson. Robson with it between the circles. Stahman with the basketball. Lions are going to come in with an entirely new unit at the next dead ball. With it, Robson looking underneath, can't find anyone. Now bounce passes it on the right of the lane to Martin. Out front, Wheeler. Wheeler, five on the clock. Wheeler's going to have to create. Stops, bounce pass to Martin. He's going to throw it up off the glass and rim. Nope. Rebound came off the side iron to Jack Kolar. 13-10 to go in the ball game. Lions leading it by 10. Manager between the circles, off on the right sideline to Austin, right baseline, Collinsworth. Collinsworth backing in against Martin, double teamed in the lane, put it up, blocked right back in his face, but he tipped it right back outside near the timeline to Totten. Totten with it, seven on the shot clock. Totten double teamed, right corner it goes to Manager. He's going to drive all the way to the hole, laid it up and in. Manager, his first two, that's a pro play. 48-36, Manager with his first two. Lions lead it by 12. Wheeler right of the circle from the right elbow from 18, got it. Wheeler, that's what we saw a lot of what he did in the first game. He's got 10. Up the floor, Manager, left wing, top of the key, Totten. Totten with the Lions having a 10-point lead, 48-38. 12:15 to go in this ball game. Top of the key, Austin. Left wing, Manager, back to Austin. He'll drive right of the lane. Kick it out to Kolar, right sideline, over to Collinsworth. Right back to Kolar on the give and go, put it up too hard. Rebound chased down, Manager saved it inbounds, put right into the hands of Bluffton. Stahman brings it up from left to right, around Collinsworth, and Collinsworth will get hit with the hold. That'll be a hold on Collinsworth, and now an official timeout on the floor. That is the first against Collinsworth, the third against the Lions as a team. 11:58 left to go here at the Harrington Center. Your score, the Mount 48, the Beavers 38 on the Mount St. Joseph Radio Network.
Now on the Mount St. Joseph campus, it's the Roar Store. Located in the Harrington Center, the Roar Store is designed to meet the needs of our students, like when you need a textbook. Students can order books exclusively online that they can pick up at the Roar Store through our new eCampus site. eCampus includes two different shipping options. Free online shipping to Textbook Delivery Hub, located in the Roar Store, or delivered to your off-campus residence. It's not just a bookstore, it's an everything store. The Roar Store, in the Harrington Center, on the campus of Mount St. Joseph University.
All right, let's take a look at the scoreboard here. Going on up in Bluffton in that ball game. 19 seconds to go in the third. Bluffton with a 2-point, 45-43 lead. Providence and Xavier in overtime, 78-78, 3:14 to go in that ball game. Tennessee by four over Florida, 9:14 to go in that one, 44-40. Purdue destroyed Penn State tonight, 80-60. And here it is 48-38, the Mount with a 10-point lead. Stammen's on the floor with Wheeler. Also on the floor, Robson, Rogers, and Martin for Bluffton. They inbound the ball to Wheeler. Long, top of the key, three, around the rim. Nope. And the rebound taken down by Kolar. Wheeler fell to the floor after the shot. He could be called for a flop, but we saw enough of that this weekend. With it, Cluxton lost the handle of the dribble. Now picks it up, gets it off to Kratzer, who just checked in for Collinsworth. Now to Kolar from the left of the circle. Three, no good. Spun that thing in and out. Wheeler got the rebound. He'll bring it up the left side. Wheeler stop and go around Weehe all the way to the hole. Now kicks it back out front. Gets it off on the left-hand side to Robson. Top of the key, Stammen. Stammen now dribbles out near the sideline. Now top of the key on the right wing. It goes to Wheeler. He's going to drive the lane. Laid up with the right hand. Fell to the floor, but got it to go. Wheeler's got 12 in the ball game. And it's a 48-40 Lions lead. Gardner's back into the ballgame now. He's going to drive it inside the lane. Pump fake underneath. Got it to go. Gardner's got 16. And it's a 10-point Lions lead again, 50-40. With it is Wheeler, top of the circle to the free throw line. Back outside. Robson for three. Got it. From the left-hand side, Robson showing some depth in his shooting. He's got seven. And the Lions lead it by seven. Up the floor, Gardner against that 2-2-1. Gets it now to Kolar. Pump fake, dumps it off underneath to Kratzer inside the lane. Kratzer jumps inside the lane, and a foul is going to be called on Bluffton down low, and that will be called against Martin. His first. That's the third against Bluffton as a team. Lions have three. 10:30 to go in this first half. Second half, excuse me. Putting it in play. Now coming into the ball game will be Cromwell. Cromwell checks in. Martin will leave after he picks up his first. 10.5 remaining. Kratzer left of the circle. Bounce pass Gardner right of the lane. Almost got it stolen away, but he regained control of the dribble. Now to Weehe, top of the key. Gardner with it. Gardner hands it off to Kolar. Kolar kicks it over to Cluxton. Back to Kolar on the right wing. Kolar drives right baseline, shut off. Nice play by Rogers. And then Kolar threw it right into the hands of Wheeler. He'll take it all the way up the floor around Cluxton, lays it up and in. That's 14 in the ballgame for Wheeler. Left wing, Kolar for three. Got it! Kolar's hit four three-pointers in the ballgame. That was his first turn in the second half. And we're halfway through the second half, and the Lions lead it by 8, 53-45. Right side, Robson dribbled it off his right foot and out of bounds. Now, Menninger will come in, and Kolar asking for a breather. Remember, he missed the last three games with that shoulder injury. Got cleared to play in this one in practice yesterday. Felt pretty good, so he's giving it a go here tonight. With it, Cluxton between the circles on the left-hand side, Weehe. Weehe looking outside, gets it off to Cluxton, hands it back off to Gardner. Gardner spins into the lane all the way to the hole, laid it up in there. Boy, he just left Stammen standing there in wonderment. 55-45. Sideline left, Rogers. Out front, it goes to Stammen. Stammen with a right-hand dribble. He's going to dribble right side, now spin it back outside. Stauman, crossover dribble, bounce pass to Cromwell, right of the lane, back over to Wheeler, baseline right. Wheeler, behind the back pass to Cromwell, now back to Wheeler, right wing, long three, hit the back iron, nope, rebound taken down by Gardner. Gardner got the rebound. That is his fifth of the night. And the Lions lead it by 10 with the basketball. Weehee, top of the circle, bounce pass Kratzer. Kratzer right elbow, back to Weehee, right of the lane, 15-footer, around the rim, won't go. Tipped up by Kratzer, it'll go, but it actually rattled itself off the top of the backboard and the shot clock, so it won't count. Checking in now, Miguel Ringer. Ringer from Cincinnati Christian High School. Checking in, 55-45. He's number 40. He played in the first half, by the way. Stauman gets it off now to Cromwell. Top of the circle. Cromwell looking down low. Kicks it on the right side to Stauman. Shut off by Gardner. Back out front. Cromwell sideline left. It goes to Wheeler. Guarded by Weehee. Wheeler's going to take Weehee to the hole. Lay it up short. And the rebound taken down by Kratzer. He'll clear it off to Cluxton. 8 minutes to go in the ball game. Lions leading it by 10, 55-45. On the left-hand side, there's going to be a foul called away from the ball on Evan Weehee for an illegal pick. Weehee with his second personal foul. And that's the fourth against the team. He and Toby Kerrigan having a discussion about it. Toby thought evidently he did, and Evan wasn't sure what he did wrong. Sideline left, it goes to Stauman, now top of the circle. Over to Ringer. Ringer, sideline left again, Wheeler. Down by 10, 7:40 to go in this ball game. Gets it off to Stauman, free throw line, fall away foot. 15-footer, no go, Kratzer with the rebound. Nate's got three rebounds tonight. Now Cluxton's gonna slow it up and bring it across the timeline. Off to Gardner. Gardner now to Menninger on the right of the lane. It goes to Kratzer. Top side Menninger. Right wing it goes to Cluxton. Back underneath to Kratzer. Spinning triple team. Ball knocked free. Out front. Cluxton's got it. Seven on the shot clock. Cluxton top of the circle. Cluxton right of the lane. Kicks it back out to Weehee. Long three. Sideline right. Nope. Rebound. Gardner chased it out of bounds. Last touch by Ringer and the Beavers. And the Lions will get it back after this official timeout. 7:04 remaining to go in this ball game. Your score, it's now the Mount 55, the Beavers 45 on the Mount St. Joseph Radio Network.
I wanted to grow my leadership skills, but with work and a busy life, how could I fit it all in? Then I learned Mount St. Joseph University offers a flexible master's program in organizational leadership. For about one Saturday a month, I studied and refined my leadership skills alongside working professionals and top-notch professors. I'm now the leader I set out to be. The Mount's organizational leadership program helped me climb higher in my career. Begin your ascent at msj.edu/msol.
You're a Lions fan. Own it. And we are the radio home of Mount St. Joseph Lions Sports, ultimatesportstalk.com. Football, basketball, wrestling, volleyball, softball, baseball. We are Cincinnati's sports website and also the home of the Ohio Baseball Weekly Show every Monday night during the baseball season. We are the home of the Mount St. Joseph Lions, ultimatesportstalk.com.
7:04 left to go in this ball game. 55-45. Lions are on top of it by 10. Here in the game. 7:04 left to go. 55-45, a 10-point lead. Lions have the basketball, and they're going to put it in play on the near side. And they do, and it goes to Cluxton. Cluxton with the basketball, top of the circle. Gets it back off to Kolar. Kolar with it on the left-hand side. Goes back out top of the circle to Collinsworth. Collinsworth hands it back off to Kolar. Kolar with it. Gets it off to Cluxton. Three on the shot clock to Kolar. Left side, got the ball partially blocked, and it didn't hit the rim, so it'll be a turnover against the Lions. 6:43 left to go in this ball game. And the Lions are on top of it by 10 at 55-45 here in this one. With the basketball, dumps it off underneath, and it goes to Stokes. Now back out front, ball not free, stolen away. Stokes lost the handle, and the Lions steal it back. 55-45, sideline right, Gardner. Gardner with it back out front. Gets it over on the right-hand side, and it goes to Cluxton. Baseline right underneath the Collinsworth double team. He'll put up the hook shot. No good. Got knocked to the floor. No call. And the rebound goes out of bounds. Back to Bluffton. Collinsworth just got knocked to the floor. Had nothing to do with what Bluffton did, but he just missed the shot after he was triple teamed. Bluffton's coming at Collinsworth right now, not just with two players, but three, and forcing him to find the open man in a hurry. 6:12 to go in this ball game. Checking the women's score up in Bluffton right now. And it is a 50-45 Bluffton lead in the fourth quarter. 5:41 left to go in it. With the basketball top of the key, Cluxton. Bounce pass Collinsworth right of the circle. 6 minutes to go in the game. On the right sideline, it goes to Collinsworth. He's double teamed again. Back outside. Top of the key, Cluxton. Pump fake. One dribble, put up the three, nope. And the rebound taken down, and a foul is going to be called on Bluffton, and that will be, looks like Cam Rogers, and it will be. That is his first and the fourth against the team, and the Lions get another shot at it. Putting it in play, Cluxton, underneath his own bucket, inbounds it to Weehy. Weehy with the basketball, bounce pass right of the lane, it goes to Gardner. Gardner, left of the lane, it goes to Cluxton for three, hit it off the sideline, and it goes out of bounds. A minute 41 in overtime, Xavier leading Providence, 82-79. Tennessee now losing to Florida, 7.5 to go in that one, 55-49. Tennessee, the number two ranked team in the country. On the sideline left is Stommen. Stommen dribbles to the left elbow. Now back over to Ringer. Lobs a pass to Stokes, left of the lane, guarded by Gardner. Now back out front, Stommen. Stommen now backs it outside. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Stommen goes left-hand side to Wheeler. Got it knocked free by Weehy, but Wheeler got it back. Top of the key, long three by Wheeler, no good. And the rebound taken down by the Lions. Cluxton will bring it across the timeline. Cluxton with the basketball. 5 minutes to go in the ball game. Cluxton with the dribble, looking to the right side. Now the left side goes to Kolar. Kolar near the sideline left. Bounce pass underneath, it goes to Gardner. Gardner backing into the lane against Ringer. Now backs it out front, off to Weehy. Underneath to Gardner, repost down low. Couple of dribbles, pump fake, put it up and in, and he's fouled. Gardner went right to work on him, and Ringer committed the foul. Gardner got the bucket. And he'll go to the line looking to complete the three-point play. He has got 20 tonight. He is 0-for-1 from the line. 57-45. Lions with a 12-point lead. Line left. Gardner put it up. Nope. And it'll be a lane violation called against Bluffton. Somebody down there moved quickly. Gardner, so get it again. Dips this one, shoots it, got it. Dane with 21 in the ball game, 58-45 Mount, 4:40 to go. Into the front court comes Stommen. Stommen out near the center circle, bounce pass Stokes, left of the circle, takes a handoff, now hands it off to Wheeler. Wheeler dribbles down to the left baseline against Weehy, laid it up, no rebound, Weehy foul called against Bluffton. Foul will be called on, it's going to be on Stokes. Stokes will commit the foul. That is his fourth of the ball game. And that's the sixth against Bluffton as a team. Full court pressure put on again by Bluffton. Kolar brings it up. Gets it off to Gardner inside the center circle. Two. Cluxton, now back to Kolar, sideline right between the circles, Gardner gets it on the left-hand side to Cluxton. Cluxton with the dribble on the left-hand side, now back up near the top of the key, off to Gardner. Gardner, 4 minutes to go in the ball game. Back over to Weehy. Weehy looked for the three from the top side. Dribbles on the right side, and he's going to be tripped and fouled. And that's going to be on Ringer. Ringer picks up his third personal, and that's going to take us to the final official timeout. 3:59 remaining. Your score, it's the Mount 58 and the Beavers 45 on the Mount St. Joseph Radio Network.
For more than a century, Mount St. Joseph University has prepared nursing leaders who serve their patients with the heart of a lion. With flexible undergraduate and graduate programs, the Mount will help you climb higher. Begin your ascent at msj.edu/nursing.
Teaching is my calling, so when I needed to renew my license, I chose Mount St. Joseph University. The Mount offers the only program in the state of Ohio that allows you to combine two education endorsements to earn a graduate degree. In less than 2 years, I combined the reading and gifted intervention specialist endorsements. Classes were convenient, fully online, and I received personal attention from my professors. The Mount helped me climb higher in my career. Begin your ascent at msj.edu/Ohio.
The School of Health Sciences at Mount St. Joseph University is a proven leader in healthcare education. The Mount offers bachelor's, master's, and doctoral degrees in nursing, including a blended online RN to BSN program and the innovative MSN Magellan program. For nearly 100 years, Mount St. Joseph University has produced outstanding healthcare professionals. Learn more at msj.edu/healthsciences.
Well, that's the final media timeout, 58-45. Lions with the lead in this one by 13 points. And they will have Evan Weehy going line left, shooting the free throw. Weehy in the ball game is scoreless. And he's now got 1 point. Weehy hits it. By the way, Xavier won in overtime tonight, 85-83. Second one by Weehy, up and in. So Weehy with two in the ballgame. Lions now lead it 60-45, equaling their biggest lead of the night. With it top of the circle on the left-hand side, it goes to Rogers. Rogers back out front, bounce pass to Stokes. Stokes top of the key to the free throw line. Down on a pass, it goes to Robson. Robson back over on the left-hand side for the long three. Robson got it from sideline left. Boy, he has shown range here tonight. 3:20 to go, and it's a 12-point Lion lead. 60-48, bringing it up the floor to the Lions. They get it off to Cluxton. Cluxton back over outside to Gardner. Gardner with the basketball. Now top of the circle to Kolar. Gets it down underneath. It goes to Collinsworth. Collinsworth gets it back to Gardner. Laid it up and it won't go. And Kolar will be going line right. 60-48, 2:59 left to go. Gardner line left, eyes it from line left, shoots it, and it is good. Gardner 22 in the ball game. Now leaving the ball game is Rogers, and back into the contest for the first time, I should say, William Layfield. Second one by Gardner, good. He's got 23 in the ball game. Layfield, a freshman, 6'3", from Lakota West. And they are here to meet. With it, top of the circle, goes to Stokes. Stokes now back out front, Stommen. Stommen, 2:45 remaining. Back over to Wheeler. Back to Stommen on the left wing. It goes to Layfield. Now Layfield gets it underneath to Robson, and he puts it up. No, but a foul is going to be called on Gardner. And it'll be a two-shot violation, so Robson will go line right. That's four fouls tonight on Gardner. And that's the 15th foul against the Mount. Line right, Robson, put it up, no good. Robson's got 10, 2:37 left to go in the ballgame. Second one up, missed everything. Boy, he hit a sideline left shot from about 30 feet earlier. Hit nothing but net. This time, he hit nothing but net. The bottom of the net. 62-48. With it on the left-hand side, Cluxton. Cluxton has it on the right-hand side of the front court. Back to Gardner. Dane with a couple of left-hand dribbles down to Weehee, and a foul called away from the ball, and that's going to be on Stammen. Mike Stammen with that. That's going to be his first, and that puts Bluffton closer to the double bonus situation. 62-48, 2:23 left to go, and Dane Gardner with 23, looking for 24 and 25. He's got a 1-1, put it up, rattled it in. Dane with 24. 63-48. Second one by Gardner, line left, put it up around the rim, fell off the front rim, and Stokes got the rebound. Bringing it up is Stammen. Gets a bounce pass to Stokes, top of the circle, sideline left, Wheeler. Wheeler outside the three-point arc, hands it back off on the left-hand side, and Layfield's going to dribble left side, now kick it back out to Stokes from the 15-foot range, got it. Stokes has got four, 2 minutes to go in the ball game, 63-50. Bringing it up the floor with the basketball on the right side is Kolar. Kolar now with it to Gardner. On the right side it goes to Weehee. Now left-hand side, Cluxton, top of the key, Weehee. Weehee hands it off to Gardner out front. Gardner spins into the lane against Stammen, backs down, put it up left side, blocked out of bounds by Stokes, but it will stay with the Lions. 9 on the shot clock, a minute 38 to go on the game clock. 63-50 the Mount. Putting it in play. Cluxton looking, inbounds the ball to Collinsworth, right of the lane. Into the lane, fell down, kicked it back to Cluxton, top of the key, Weehee for three, nope. And the rebound taken down by the Beavers. They get it off to Layfield, into the front court. Layfield's going to go all the way to the hole, lay it up, no, but a foul will be called on Weehee. Weehee committing the foul on Layfield, and Layfield will go line right. That is the third foul on Weehee. Lions do not need to let Bluffton score points with the clock stopped. Right now they lead by 13 with a minute 25 to go. Line right, Layfield shoots it, got it. 63-51. Lions with a 12-point lead. Layfield trying to cut into it. Spins it around, no good. Rebound, Collinsworth. Collinsworth tonight, off the glass, has got six rebounds. Cluxton near the center circle with the right-hand dribble. Feeds it right side to Gardner outside the arc. Now between the circles to Cluxton. Hands it off to Kolar. Kolar left side, got it off to Weehee. Now top of the key to Collinsworth for three, no good. Rebound taken down by Weehee. Back out front, Cluxton. And Cluxton is going to dribble off some more clock. We're under a minute to go, 50 seconds to go in the ballgame. Weehee with it, now to Kolar. Bounce pass, Collinsworth. Collinsworth, eight on the shot clock inside the circle. Got the ball knocked out of bounds by Wheeler, and it will go back to the Lions with 41.5 seconds to go. Five on the shot clock. Lions will put it in play. Putting it in play for the Lions is going to be Cluxton. Cluxton's going to lob it underneath the basket to Collinsworth. Laid it up on the rim. Nope. And the rebound taken down by Bluffton. They get the ball up the floor to Wheeler. Wheeler goes all the way to the bucket, and a reach and foul called on Willard Cluxton. Why in the world would you do that? 63-51, you've got a 12-point lead. The layup means nothing. And Cluxton reaches in and commits the foul on Wheeler, and he'll put it up and in. Wheeler with 15 in the ball game. Boy, he is a good-looking freshman. Second one around the rim. He's got 16. Lions lead it by 10. Inbounds pass made to Cluxton, and a foul will be called by Stammen. 29 seconds to go, and it appears we're going to milk this thing for all it's worth. 57-56, Mount Women on top of Bluffton. 47 seconds to go in the game. Lions have a one-point lead up in Bluffton, 47 seconds remaining. Line left, Cluxton, put it up and in. Willard with his first point of the night. Ball on his hip, now one dribble, up again, good again. That's two in the ball game for Cluxton. 65-53 Lions. Up the floor on the left-hand side is Wheeler. Now to Stahman. Stahman, 19 seconds to go to the free throw line. Bounce pass, Layfield, out front Stokes. Long three, right of the circle. Nope. Rebound, taken down, and another foul on Cluxton. Going for the rebound. 11.3, and that's going to do it for Willard Cluxton. So Willard will foul out of the ball game, and Danny Austin will come in to the contest. Cluxton fouls out in the ball game with 2 points, both from the free throw line. 11.3 seconds to go, and line right is Bruns. Bruns puts up the front end, got it. Bruns with four, 11.3 left to go, Lions by 11. Second one, good again by Bruns. He's got five in the ball game, 2 for 2 from the line, full court pressure, and now Weehee has to take a timeout because he can't get the ball in bounds. I'll tell you, the last minute of this ball game, the Lions have done just about everything they can do to blow the lead. Nonetheless, they still lead it by 10, 65-55. They're committing fouls that they shouldn't commit. They can't get the ball inbounds. And yet they still have a 65-55 lead. Their record here at home will go to 6-2. Now Gardner's going to put the ball in play. 11.3 seconds to go. Gardner will put it in play. Looking, inbounds the ball to Weehee. Now back to Austin. Austin will dribble it across, and that's going to do it. Your final score here tonight from the Harrington Center. It is the Lions 65 and Bluffton 55. The Lions now move their record to 7-13 overall. They are 6-7 in the Heartland Conference. Meanwhile, Bluffton is now 4-16 overall, and they are 2-12 in the Heartland Conference, and they are 1-7 on the road this year. Your final score again tonight, the Mount 65 and the Beavers 55. We'll be back to give you the stat story and go over and talk with head coach Toby Kerrigan after these timeouts.
Take your game to new heights at Mount St. Joseph University, where Division III champions are made. We coach our Lions to become leaders who will win on the field and in their career. With 23 athletic teams and cutting-edge facilities, we are the NCAA Division III university in Greater Cincinnati. Are you ready to compete with the heart of a Lion and become our next champion? Learn more at msjlions.com.
Changing lives is what great teachers do, and as I saw more students struggling to read, I looked to Mount St. Joseph University for help. The Mount is a national leader in reading science with highly effective research-based methods. Their faculty equipped me to teach students with a range of learning differences, and I was able to make an immediate impact in the classroom. The Mount's fully online reading science program helped me climb higher in my career, but more importantly, is improving the lives of my students. Begin your ascent at msj.edu/read.
Where are you headed? Where would you like to go? New heights, right? At Mount St. Joseph University, we integrate academic excellence, real-world experience, and individual attention so that you can climb higher. Begin your ascent at msj.edu.
Well, going on up in Bluffton right now, there's 23 seconds left to go in that one, in the women's game. And right now, the Mount is leading it by a point, 59 to 58. There's a timeout on the floor up there. 59-58, the Mount leads it. 22 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter of play in that one. But here tonight, the Lions end up winning it by the final score of 65-55. Lions were led tonight in scoring by Dane Gardner. Gardner had 24 points, and Luke Collinsworth had 21 to pace the way for the Lions here this evening. Jack Kolar coming back from that shoulder injury, 12 points in the contest. And then the Lions had four players with 2 points each. Cluxton, Weehe, Menninger, and Austin each had 2 points in the ball game for the Lions. The Lions only had seven players here tonight score for them in the ball game. Bluffton, that was a different story. They had two players in double figures. Wheeler had 16 points, and Robson had 10, mainly on a couple of three-pointers late in the ball game. Rose had 9 points in the contest for Bluffton. It was 6 points for Stokes and then 5 points each for Bruns and Stammen in the ball game. 2 points to Rogers and then 1 point each for Layfield and Martin in the contest. Lions shot 23 of 51 for 45% in the ball game. Bluffton, 20 of 51 for 39.2%. So both teams put up 51 shots, but the Lions hit three more in the contest. The Lions also hit 6 of 24 from three-point range for 25%, while Bluffton was 7 of 17 for 41% in the ball game. Lions from the line, 13 of 15, 87%, and for Bluffton, they were 8 of 12 for also 67% in the ball game. Lions win it here tonight by 10. We'll be back to talk with the coach and the star of the game after this.
In the game of life, it's not how far you can throw the ball.
It's not how high you can fly.
It's not how fast you can run.
Or how many touchdowns you can score that matters.
It's really how you play the game that counts.
Because the game only lasts four quarters.
For a few years.
For that moment in time.
Good sportsmanship.
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 Lasts a lifetime.
This is the story of a boy who didn't talk for a long time. The boy liked things to always be the same. Any changes would scare and upset him. The unknown was an unfriendly place. The boy was very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where they couldn't get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. He wasn't trying to be mean, it just made him feel uncomfortable. Sometimes he would flap his arms again and again.
One day, I found out I have something called autism. My family got me help. Slowly, I found my voice and learned all the way I could live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
Dane Gardner standing up here beside us now here on the start of the game here this evening. Dane, quite an evening for you tonight. I'm going to get these stats correct. 10 for 11 from the field. You were 4 of 6 from the free throw line, 4 rebounds, 2 assists, a steal. You had 4 fouls. You had to do something wrong tonight. You also missed one shot, which I'll ask you about here in a minute. But nonetheless, new career high, 24 points. Congratulations. What a game for you tonight.
Yeah, we started off early. They said, let's get it to Dane in the post. And then we started working with Luke, too. He had 21 as well. And every time we kept feeding the post, we just thought that was the haymaker.
It was outstanding here this evening, watching you just continually take the ball down low, and you were able to put the ball. You were able to do just about anything you wanted to down low, weren't you?
Yeah, it felt like that, honestly. Like, every time they hit me in the post, I hear everyone telling me to score, and that just gives me confidence to go score.
You know, what was also interesting was you're getting that right hand down now to where you can use it and go in the opposite direction and use that right hand and to make it very successful for you.
Yeah, teams know that I'm a lefty, and they know that that's my strong suit, so every time they start shutting that off, then I know I can go drop step middle. And I hear the other team's coach saying no left every single time, so then when I know that their team's trying to do that, the right's wide open.
What's been the key for you and Luke in the last three ball games? You guys have really started playing well off of each other.
I think it's just we know where we stand with each other. I mean, Luke, every time I know Luke's working, we try and get him working in the post, and then every time I'm working, we try and get me working in the post. And that's really the same thing for everybody. Whoever has the hot hand, we try and feed them and let them work.
It's kind of a three-headed dragon. Then you bring Kratzer in, and he starts being physical down low.
Yeah, Nate gives us a good breather, especially like when Bluffton had two big guys down there, and Nate's like a cleanup guy. He bangs with everybody, gets boards, passes well. He just does everything that you need him to do.
Yeah, you're almost in a position, and I hate to say this, but you can't lose right now. You've got to win every game in order to qualify for the tourney, don't you?
Yeah, it's a win. We got to basically win every game. That's what we're looking to do, at least. And that's what we're looking to do, honestly. And honestly, that's all I can say. We're just looking to win games and keep playing well.
Dr. Williams here behind us. I had to shake hands with him to say hello. One final question, the missed shot. What happened, Dane? You blew a perfect night.
I was looking for the perfect night, and I knew in my head, I was like, ooh, I know I'm perfect from the field right now, but I thought I saw open lane. I thought they were going to call a foul, but hey.
Great game.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
Absolutely fantastic. Dane Gardner, 24 points. Congratulations. New career high for the Lions sophomore power forward. Toby, I know you're a little bit happier now after this one. 10-point victory for the team here tonight. I don't think I've ever seen Dane Gardner play a better ball game.
Dane's been really good. He's been aggressive, hasn't he, last three games probably.
So, absolutely.
Yeah, he's been playing well.
I asked him the question, what has been the key for him and Luke? They have really been playing well together lately.
Yeah, I mean, I think they're being a little more patient, I think, when they catch the ball. They don't try to go right away. I mean, Luke's getting doubled every time he catches it now. So, and he's getting better. It's still, you know, he's still learning every time he gets doubled. He learns, and then sometimes we got to remind him he's going to get doubled, but. No, him and Dane have both been really aggressive, and so, you know, they've been able to keep us in games.
The other thing with Dane is that he has been going to his right hand. He can use now both his right and left hand down low, and that's been impressive over the last few games.
Yeah, and he's been working on it. So, you know, he's been working on it. So it shows, and obviously he gets confident in himself to be able to do it, and it's been showing the last couple games.
You know, they came back in the second half, or in the first half, and cut it to a 2-point lead. And I thought one of the turning points in the ball game here, Coach, was when Menninger decided that he was going to drive the basketball out of the corner and put it in on a layup, and that really turned the tide in this ball game. Was that a point that you saw too?
Yeah, that was big. I mean, shot clock was running down. That's when Matt's at his best, when the shot clock's running down, because he's got to try to score, and he's good at it. I think he had one of those. Rose Holman maybe there tonight. So, but no, I mean, you can't be passing it when the shot clock's at five, and he got to the rim.
This is a big win. Now you got to carry it over up to Manchester on Saturday.
Yep, it's always a tough place to play, and obviously we're happy to have Jack back. You know, scored 12
absolutely.
Points outside shots going in tonight. So,
yep,
know, look, score if we don't have Jack's 12.
Yeah.
Might be a little different.
Coach, I'm glad you brought him up because he was extremely important in this ballgame for us.
Made some big shots, and I played him more than I wanted to. But
you got to do what you got
to
do.
It was hard not to have him out there. I know he was probably sucking wind a little bit.
Yep.
But we were happy to have him back out there.
Big win tonight. Congrats, Coach. Go enjoy it.
Thanks, Dave. Appreciate it.
Toby Kerrigan after tonight's ballgame. Let's wrap it up here from the Harrington Center. And let you know that we want to thank, as we just saw, Dr. Williams for allowing us permission to broadcast these games here tonight. Also to Melanie Wagner, our athletic director here at Mount St. Joseph, Blake Watson, the sports information director. Our thanks to both coaches tonight, Guy Neal and Toby Kerrigan. Our thanks to all of our sponsors here this evening, to Greg Mitchell, our producer, but most of all, our thanks go out to you for listening here tonight on Ultimate Sports Talk and YouTube. I'm Dave Mitchell reminding you once again your final score here tonight. It was the Lions 65 and the Beavers 55. And in the women's game tonight, they also won up in Bluffton 62-58. Congratulations to them. We'll see you all on Saturday from Manchester. I'm Dave Mitchell. Have a good night, everybody.